metaverse are supposed to be dependent on data from Apple, Windows, Linux. You can log on to a Microsoft Office or whatever.
Best thing to do, I think, is try it out and see. Because I know you can change some things some ways, but I'm pretty sure there's a way you can't. If I sent you something and you wanted to send it off to somebody else, for instance, you can't. It's impossible to change. It won't let you.
What I'm trying to say is that there are two different things.
Yeah. Yes.
I think it's the timestamp that can't be changed, but the words can be changed. But it's only the timestamp that can't be changed, as far as I know. Unless you scan it and put it in either a PDF file or a document, unless
set it in. DOC.
Yeah. So.
.com.
Okay, I'm no expert on it, so I'll have to check it out.
But anyways, maybe it'll just make people read things that they're signing, or they think before they go into a job with someone. Sometimes you're offering yourself that you're going to write for these people once a week or once a month, and what kind of a contract you're getting into. So
I find that the Federation of BC Writers is a really good resource for legal type questions and things of that nature.
Well, we're just, I think we probably have raised enough doubts now, which I think is always a good thing, because I'm trying to get people thinking about that they're running a business, and we should look into some of the things. How do you develop that business? We're not going to believe everyone that's trying to sell us something now. What else are we going to look at? There were 20 things covered on that first page, and I have one little booklet. This is awful with 40 people, but there's so many resources. Most people don't collect booklets today. I know this is an 08, and I deliberately bought it, because sometimes it's a good idea to look at something 6 years old and see how many of them existed.
How
different publications, publishing companies, are they changing? Are they disappearing? And it's one reason why people, when they're going to send something and they look up addresses, they go on the internet and see what it says today. Have they moved? What are they doing? But there are resources for looking up all periodicals, newspapers. Maybe anyone here writing plays? So there's play scripts. Or anyone here writing video or film stories? Or they're just hoping that their novel will get selected for a film?
I have videos that go back.
Uh-huh.
I have pictures that go back to the 1800s.
Right.
And the story that I want to write.
Mm-hmm.
And
you want to get copyright to use them? Or you already own them? They're already your property.
Already, I own them.
Mm-hmm.
They've been passed on to me. And
well, it's an excellent resource.
Then I have a reenactment of which I took of Sitting Bull coming to Canada in July 1st, 2008, and it was an hour when he came and went back.
Right.
And I grew up within 25 miles of sitting where Sitting Bull was squatted in Canada. So.
So if you have something, you know, very exciting and ready for agents and editors to look at, then going to Surrey International Writers Conference is a place where you can take your ideas and meet with someone for 10, 15 minutes and see if they're interested to go further. Sometimes at bigger conferences, they have 16 agents at the end of October in Surrey at the big hotel. And only two editors are listed, but so there are 18 people you can talk directly to. But you can also benefit from the other speakers who are presenting workshops during the days there and see whose attention you could get. It's wonderful to go and listen to all the famous international people at Gravel Island, which is on virtually the same days, end of October, or third week, to hear them read their work or be interviewed, but you don't do business with them. You don't talk to agents and editors at a reader's performance conference. So that's something when you're looking at, am I going to reach out to people? There are very few agents in Vancouver. Does anybody know one?
Sally.
Yes. I know. How many of you actually looked into publishers? Because I got mostly people writing books here, right? We said we had a few poets. Are any of the poets not wanting books? How many people have actually met with a book publisher? You've actually gone to an office here in Vancouver. Was that the only hand I saw? Where would you meet one of these people from a Vancouver or area publishing company without going to their office? Where's the best place to talk to them?
When they come to town for...
You're talking about people from Toronto now?
Well, yeah. If anybody comes from out of town mm-hmm. to do a workshop or a seminar,
right.
That's a publisher, mm-hmm. is that a good person to talk to?
How many would like to be published in BC by a BC person? Do you just sort of have a little sign on the subway, like a Vienna writer? How are you going to? Yes.
Well, there's social media can help you, and there are writing sites, art sites even, that will give you attention. And actually, if you have followers and people who your coffee or like publishers and stuff will pick you up or want to pick you up.
I think you still have to ask them. I think it's wonderful. How many people have a website? How many are blogging? How many have a website?
So we've got
more than half of you have websites or are blogging or are on the internet. And the more you can build up your reputation, and it talks about building up your bibliography and biography and your whole background is very good. But there's nothing beats them getting to know you personally as well as seeing some of your work. I know postage is terrible, but sending query letters, I still think the printed ones with some people is more active than sending email queries to people. I found that going to readings, even in this building, you will meet people who are working on small publishing houses. I found that at the literary publishing houses, sometimes as much as 3/4 of the staff are also writing. Mm-hmm. You know, they've been published locally, maybe with their own company, with others locally, and they all want to hit New York, London, England, but they all start locally. But who knows someone, a live human being,